Part 3 of my tour of Nepal's capital Kathmandu, Patan Darbar Square. This is my 14th travel video vlog of the tour which I started from Kolkata, going through Darjeeling, Gangtok, Nepal, ending in Dehradun over a period of 1 month. I crossed over to Nepal 2 weeks after I started from Kolkata to visit Kathmandu, and I was there for about 10 days. Kathmandu has a large number of tourist attractions, in fact 7 UNESCO World Heritage Sites. And at the topmost of the list is Kathmandu Darbar Square, which was my 12th travel blog. Another one within the city is Swayambhunath, a very important pilgrimage site for Buddhist religion, which was my previous video, and the link to that is given on the top right corner. The next one would be Narayanahiti Palace Museum, which I could not visit because it was closed whenever I went there. There is a tourist hotspot called Thamal, mainly a shopping center. Another important Buddhist pilgrimage site is Baudhanath with a dome-shaped stupa. Very close by is Sri Pashupatinath Temple, the oldest Hindu temple in Nepal and a very revered and historic place and a pilgrimage site. Just outside the limits of Kathmandu town is another Darbar Square at Lalitpur called Patan Darbar Square. A similar one is there at Bhaktapur, again outside Kathmandu city limits, but very close by. A tour of all these places can be done in about 2 to 3 days with good planning. So this video is about Patan Darbar Square, situated at a place called Lalitpur, which is about 7 kilometers from Kathmandu city center. Lalitpur, where the Patan Darbar Square is situated, is called the City of Fine Arts. Lalitpur has finest traditional crafts and rich artistic heritage. Over the centuries, it has created a large number of talented artists and craftsmen, and that tradition is still maintained by the city. And I am at Lalitpur on the way to Patan Darbar Square. And on both sides of this road are shops selling those arts and artifacts, mainly targeting tourists. All the 3 royal palaces in the Kathmandu Valley, all of which are within the UNESCO World Heritage Sites, were small cities developed by independent kingdoms over different centuries. And Patan Darbar Square is the oldest among the 3. And so this is it. And this was a small town several centuries ago, which has a palace, a number of temples, residential areas and so on. It was a small town, it cannot be compared to the size of the present towns. So this place could be the center of that town, with the palaces, the courtyards, the temples and all those associated things which a town requires. If you see the history of the town, it was developed sometime during the 3rd century, but it probably established and started flourishing during the 12th century onwards. The Malla dynasty was ruling Kathmandu at that time, and it was King Veeradeva that created or developed this town. The later kings of the Malla dynasty introduced several palaces, courtyards, temples and so on. The present day Lalitpur town has expanded outwards with Patan as its center. And with the burst of tourist activity, it has become more tourist dependent economy. Tourism industry is probably giving good employment opportunities to a large number of people here, especially to those skilled craftsmen. And so if you want to do some shopping of handicrafts in wood, bronze and other metals, clothes, this is the place. Well, I didn't do any shopping, but I saw a number of shops that is selling all these handcrafted artifacts. So let's go and see what exactly is there. So this is the entrance to the Patan Darbar Square compounds, and all foreigners have to take tickets. Before I go into the details, let me share this with you. I shot all these videos with my DSLR and I was experimenting with the manual settings on the camera. Well, it didn't come out very well. The video is shaky and I apologize for it. I had taken a lot of videos during my one full day trip, but I haven't put even 1/3 of all those videos in here because all of them are not good. I have tried several software to reduce the shake in the videos but could not. So please bear with me on this one. I have tried my best and I have only put those videos which is viewable. But I have included almost all important places. Most importantly, I have learned about the mistakes and I have tried to correct them in my subsequent videos. Anyway, let me start this one officially. Patan Darbar Square was a small town developed at around 3rd century. But most of the buildings that can be seen there, like the palace compound, the courtyards, the temples, the other residential buildings, were all built around the 16th century. If you see the history of Nepal, Malla dynasty ruled over the Kathmandu Valley from around 12th century till around 16th century. If you look at the broad history, and not just in Nepal, that is throughout the world, all kinds of dynasties, kingdoms and even civilizations have a growth, a peak and a decline phase. The Mellal dynasty had a similar trajectory. The peak period of the dynasty was around the 16th century, and the peak period means economic affluence. And during their peak period, the Mellal kings constructed a number of palaces, courtyards, temples and other buildings and structures. So what we see now is the contributions from that phase, and one particular king, Siddha Narasimha Mellal, developed most of these palace structures, temples and other buildings and structures. There were several contributions from previous kings as well, but Nepal, as you know, is earthquake prone. Every earthquake brings destruction, and there could be external events that wars that damage the places. And even the 2015 earthquake damaged a lot of buildings and structures here. During its peak period, it is said there is about 55 temples and other structures at this place, but only 1/3 of them remains. Another important facet of Nepal is that it is a confluence of Hindu and Buddhist religions, and that is evident in this place. So there are both Hindu and Buddhist temples at this place. One difference with my Kathmandu Darbar Square visit and this one was that here I got the services of a good guide. So I was able to understand the place in much more detail, mainly about the architecture and history of the structures and places. Another difference with Kathmandu Darbar Square and this one is visible on the map. The sites and important places to visit are not so spread out and scattered as in Kathmandu Darbar Square. Here the number of structures are less and all of them are within a defined compound. The most important one would be Krishna Mandir from the 17th century. It is a stone structure and the sculptures on the first floor of the temple depict Mahabharata and on the second floor Ramayana, two great epics of Hindu religion. The second main temple and a very unique one at that is the Taleju Bhavani temple. Taleju Bhavani was the patron god of the Mellal dynasty and their kings. Taleju Bhavani is considered a form of goddess Durga. And there used to be animal sacrifices in these temples, but probably not anymore. These temples can be found in all the three Darbar squares, and the one in Bhaktapur is the oldest. This is the courtyard of the temple and it is only opened once every year. As I said before, Nepal is a confluence of Hinduism and Buddhism. This one is the Hiranyavarna or Suvarna Mahavira Buddhist temple. It is commonly referred to as the Golden Temple as the bronze-made statues and other sculptures are covered in gold. And here is one of the symbols of Tibetan Buddhist religion, the Vajra or a thunderbolt, and in Tibetan language Dorje. All the other temples, and most of them Hindu temples, are carved in stone or wood, but this one is mostly in bronze. A lot of very unique, intricate bronze figures and statues make this one stand out from the other temples in this place. The temple priest is a boy below the age of 12, and every month there is a new priest. Most of these Buddhist temples are in fact monasteries, where the Buddhist monks live together, conduct their prayers, studies and all that. This temple is also a monastery, and it is within a compound or a structure with the name, I think, is Kwabadahul. This temple is thought to have been built between the 12th and the 14th century, and it is truly an architectural marvel because of the different bronze statues and sculptures. Most of the construction in bronze, indeed the sculptures and other figures, are covered in gold. And so this one stands out from the rest. Within the palace compound of Pathan Darbar Square is a museum. Simply called the Pathan Museum, it is considered as one of the best museums in Asia. Most of the artifacts here are bronze statues connected with Buddhism and especially the statue of Sri Buddha. But again, the confluence of Hinduism and Buddhism is again evident here. So there are exhibits of Hindu gods and goddesses and of Buddhist sculptures. It is not a very large museum. If you want to see it in detail, you can probably spend about 2 hours at the max in this place. But there is indeed a wide variety of artifacts from different centuries. Lalitpur and Pathan is known for its rich cultural heritage, especially the tradition of arts and crafts, specifically making of the metallic and stone carving statues. So the museum is a reflection of the cultural heritage of Lalitpur. The Austrian government seems to have contributed to the museum in developing it and maintaining it. The project is also supported by UNESCO, and it is one among the UNESCO's World Heritage Sites. The museum is located in the northern part of the Darbar Square Palace complex. Similar to the other Darbar Squares in Kathmandu Valley, the Patan Darbar Square, mainly the palace and the temples and other structures, have been constructed over different time periods, over different centuries. At the time I was there, in August 2018, I was not able to see the entire palace in detail. There was entry restrictions to the palace itself because of the damage caused by the earthquake. So I was only able to see the courtyards of the palace. The Newari style architecture is clearly visible at these places. Look at the windows. It is a very unique type of construction. Right, now this completes the number of video clips I could put in this, like the number of video clips I could salvage from my collection of those, you know, shaky videos. Well, it's a shame I couldn't put more into this, because the place is indeed very beautiful. I was there for one full day, took a lot of videos, but only about 1/10 of that has gone into this video. I enjoyed visit to Patan Darbar Square because I got a good guide. He was able to explain most of the things to me. And then when I went there, the day I went there, there was not much crowd. There was not many tourists. Perhaps it was off season, and also because I went there early. If you do not take a guide or you do not have any other recourse to understand what you're seeing, like what are these temples, what are these structures, they're just merely stone, metal, wood and all that, nothing more. Initially it will look all very unique, but then the uniqueness disappears. You do not have a better understanding of the difference between the temples and the sculptures and all those things. So it is better to have a guide for two-way communication. You can ask any number of questions. If the guide is good, you will get much more understanding. Or otherwise, you probably do some research, use some books or other materials to understand the place. To summarize the place, uniqueness of Newari architecture, confluence of Hinduism and Buddhism, appealing architecture in stone, wood and metal. The most important structures are the Krishna Temple, the Taleju Bhavani Temple and the Golden Temple. And this is me going back from the place, and this is the end of Patan Darbar Square vlog. But then I went to Bhaktapur Darbar Square the next day, and this is a preview of my next vlog, which is about Bhaktapur Darbar Square. There again I got a guide, but I think not a good one. At least in comparison with the guide I took today. So that video vlog is my next one. I hope you must have enjoyed this vlog in spite of the shaky videos. If you do, please do like the video and share it with your friends, and also subscribe to my channel. And the link to my next video vlog is given here, the right side one. Thank you.